Satan teaches to swim to let us drown. He didn't build his home in us to move away. He didn't lift us up to let us down. Lift us up to let us down. He didn't lift us up to let us down. He's ever interceding to the Father for his children. Yes, he's ever interceding to the Father. Interceding. come boldly to the throne. Just like sheep we've gone astray, struggling 'neath a debt we could not pay, not ever hoping to renew the love and fellowship that we once knew. But he began to intercede, crying, "Father, please forgive, I plead." And as the nails pierced in his hand, God once again reached out to man, and he's ever linger. can he not his mercies? Mercies for you and for me.
Someone Shout of acclamation and hail. that joy shall flood my heart, and I shall bow in humble adoration, and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul,
from him
what willingly he gave. Could they keep him in the grave? They could not.
Hold on, my child.
lost inside. Now to invest your seed of faith in God, in mountains you can't move. You have risked your life for things you cannot prove. Just to give the things you cannot keep, for things you cannot lose. That's the way to find the joy God has for you. Hold on, my child. Begins with his dissection of the word, and with all of his craft and subtlety, the serpent twists the simple truths they heard. While hanging in the balance is a world that has been placed at their command. All their unborn children die as both of them bow down to Satan's hand. Just before the evening, in the cool of the day, they hear the voice of God as he is walking. And they can't abide his presence, so they try to hide away. But still they hear the sound as he is calling. Hello, 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 where are you? Hello. Thank you.
summer now, the gardener and his wife are in the field. And it seems that thorns and thistles are the only crops his struggles ever yield. He eats his meals in sorrow till he sinks into the dust whence he came. But all down through the ages, he can hear the Maker calling out his name. Adam, Adam, where are you? Adam, Adam, I love you. My heart was distressed 'neath Jehovah's dread frown, and low in the pit where my sins drag me down, I cry to the Lord from the deep miry clay, who tenderly brought me out to gold and day. He brought me out of the miry clay. He set my feet on the rock to stay. He puts a song in my soul today, a song of praise. Hallelujah, hallelujah, I have found him whom my soul so long has craved. Jesus satisfies my longing. Through his blood I now am saved. The gates and doors are barred, all the windows fastened down. Spent the night in sleeplessness and rose at every sound. Half in hopeless sorrow and half in fear the day would find the soldiers breaking through to drag us all away. Just before the sunrise, I heard something at the wall. The gate began to rattle and a voice began to call. I hurried to the window and looked down into the street, expecting swords and torches and the sounds of soldiers' feet. There was no one there but Mary, so I went down to let her in. John stood there beside me as she told us where she'd been. She said they moved him in the night, and none of us knows where. The stone's been rolled away, and now his body isn't there. We both ran for the garden, then John ran on ahead. We found the stone and the empty tomb just the way that Mary said. But the winding sheet they wrapped him in was just an empty shell. The hour where they'd taken him was more than I could tell.
strange it happened there, but just what I didn't know. John believed the miracle, but I just turned to go. Circumstances, speculations couldn't lift me very high, 'cause I seen them crucify him, then I saw him die. Back inside the house again, the guilt and anguish came. Everything I promised him just added to my shame. When at last it came to choices, I denied I knew his name. And even if he was alive, it wouldn't be the same. But suddenly the air was filled with a strange and sweet perfume. The light that shone from everywhere drove shadows from the room. Jesus stood before me with his arms held open wide, and I fell down on my knees and just clung to him and cried. He raised me to my feet, and as I looked into his eyes, love was shining out from him like the sunlight from the sky. Guilt in my confusion disappeared in sweet release. Every fear I ever had just melted into peace.